Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm coming to you from Shaftesbury, Vermont right now. I'm even wearing my flannel from the Vermont Flannel Company, so I'm definitely fully embracing where I am right now. I have this real treat for you today. I have this newly renovated historic home behind me. It actually used to be a schoolhouse back in the day, so it's pretty cool. And it was actually featured on Airbnb's magazine back in fall 2018. So it's featured in Airbnb magazine, and it's definitely a first for this channel. It's pretty cool. But I'm also currently standing on a 270-acre farm, so it's also very historic as well. It's actually a working farm still, it's still active, and it's a fourth-generation run farm, so it definitely has a really cool historical feature for this entire listing. But if you want to check out this really cool, newly renovated historic home on Airbnb, the listing is down in the video description as usual, so be sure to check that out. Also, if you want to save money on this listing or any other Airbnb anywhere in the world, my Airbnb code is down there as well. So go ahead and check that out. If you use my code, you save money, I save money off of both of our next trips. It's a win-win for the both of us. So without further ado now, let's hop into a tour of this newly renovated historic home in Shaftesbury, Vermont. When you begin to pull up to the schoolhouse, this is what you're going to see. The schoolhouse is located off on the right-hand side, and there's a big sign that says schoolhouse, and you can't miss it. This is the first glimpse of the exterior you're gonna see as you go down the driveway in your car, and there's plenty of parking here, probably for enough 5 or 6 cars. It's quite large, but now when you get a little bit closer, this is kind of the front and the main entryway. You're gonna see again, number 1103 is the schoolhouse, but there's actually a lot to cover on the grounds here, you know, throughout the property. So right here, the fire pit. There's 4 chairs right here, plenty of space for some s'mores or some hot dogs. You get a little bit closer now. This is my favorite side of the exterior, my favorite side of the house. You know, this beautiful wall with all these flowers and all these vines, and it's really, really well maintained by the Airbnb hosts here. Next, we're going to head to the main outdoor deck area, which is directly attached to the schoolhouse. You have this one nice little outdoor couch with enough seating for 4 people. Directly opposite of that is this nice stainless steel grill, and have some more seating options in this area. It's kind of the main outdoor dining room table. So again, plenty of space for a small group or a family, with some gorgeous views in the background of the farm and then all the mountains in the background. But from this angle, you can kind of see a better view of the farm as well. This is what you kind of know the schoolhouse looks out onto. The schoolhouse on the right hand side in this shot, and kind of one of the main barns, one of the main buildings on the farm is there. It's kind of another building as well you can gaze out onto, but a really, really peaceful setup. Absolutely loved this area Airbnb is in. This is now the highlights of all the outdoor amenities. There's a lot to cover here. This is right next to the house, like a 5-second walk, but I don't know where to start. There's so much to cover, but I guess I'll start right here. This is kind of the little fire pit. It's even enough chairs right here for 2 people, and they're looking out to this gorgeous view again of the farms and the mountains in the background. You have this really, really huge hot tub, but you can see the house in the background right there. There's also an outdoor shower, which is really a nice touch. Didn't think about that, but then you actually kind of peer over more towards the right hand side to see this really cool sauna. I believe it's a Scandinavian style sauna. I used some when I was in Norway and Finland earlier this year, but really, really nice. Again, a beautiful view out into the farm and at the mountains in the background. So definitely an amazing kind of way to start or to end your day at the farm. But this hot tub as well can definitely not be ignored. It was quite large, can probably fit 3 or 4 people inside of it quite easily. And again, you have the gorgeous views of the farm and the houses off the left hand side and the mountains. But again, it was quite spacious, had all the kind of typical jets and all the setups, and it was really, really relaxing just to kind of sip, you know, my morning coffee here to start my day out. We're now finally going to head inside to the schoolhouse. We're gonna inch a little bit closer, and the first room we're going to enter is the mud room. So there's a bunch of hangers off to one side next to the door. There's plenty of storage space for your jackets, actually some bathrobes that the host left behind to use in the hot tub. But now we're finally going to enter into the main room. There's a very open floor plan. This is what I probably call the main living room or family room area. There's a lot to cover here. Again, there's so many different sitting options. You have the TV in one corner. You have some really cool decorations like the guitar, and there's another bench off to one side. There's a very, you know, tall spiral staircase which leads to the loft bedroom. And from this angle, you can see the kitchen and some more space there in the background. So there's so much to do and see here. I obviously love the interior design, but this one corner in particular has this really nice, you know, plasma plasma, there's flat screen TV, and there's lots of kind of books and games here and a first aid kit, and there's lots of different things to kind of keep you entertained, as if the hot tub and kind of everything else out there isn't already enough. But they have puzzles down here as well, games, a speaker, first aid kit, and binoculars, decorations, lots to do and see, and plenty of sitting options from all these chairs on this one side. There's another chair then on this end and a couch, so really, really nicely done area. Now right next to that space is the dining and kitchen room area. So there's three seats on this one end of the table and a bench on the other side, so there's plenty of space and sitting for six people. Then right next to that is this nice wood burning stove, kind of goes all the way up top here, and some nice brickwork. And this is kind of looking into the kitchen area, and there's plenty to see and do in this area as well. We're gonna get a little bit closer. It's really a state-of-the-art kitchen. You have a nice kind of island right here and three additional, you know, little stools, little sitting areas right there. And this is kind of the sink area. And they left kind of a few goodies as well for when you check in. So they have this one really, really well done. It's very in-depth, a welcome guide. So everything from food recommendations to hikes to activities in the area. It was very, very thorough. They also left some eggs and the local chickens at their farm. There's some soap right here, also locally made. And there's also some locally made chocolate as well. So everything is done in the area or by the hosts themselves. So it's really a nice touch. Opposite of that, this is the last wall in the kitchen. So everything you see right here, very, you know, shiny and state of the art and looks very new appliances to me. And this kitchen was absolutely fully stocked. Just everything imaginable you might need, from toasters to knives to utensils to plates, everything is there. Now we're going to check out the two other rooms on the ground floor of the schoolhouse. The first being the bathroom right here. As soon as you walk here, you're going to see the bathtub on the left-hand side. It has these really beautiful gray tiles. I really loved that setup there. And then on the opposite end, right next to the bathtub, is the toilet and the sink area. You have this nice mirror off on one side, or right on top of this sink. And actually then right above the toilet area, you have these nice kind of little paintings, these nice photos. There's some more storage up top, some more towels, all the basic bathroom amenities you might need. The last room we'll cover on the ground floor is the bedroom. This is the ground floor bedroom. Again, there's two bedrooms and there's one bath in the schoolhouse. This is where I slept though. Absolutely love the interior design, all the decorations in this space, everything from the whitewashed walls to all the bedding to all the paintings and the curtains, just perfectly matched in my opinion the rest of the decor in this schoolhouse. The last room we'll cover now in this newly renovated home is the loft bedroom up top. So we're gonna get there via the spiral staircase. This is actually kind of a nice view to give you some more perspective looking down to the main family room area. But welcome to the loft bedroom. Absolutely love this space, and I kind of really enjoyed how it's slightly different from the downstairs bedroom. So kind of all the decor and the color scheme is slightly different from the downstairs bedroom, but I thought again kind of really fit the rest of the mood of this entire schoolhouse overall. It was really well done. You have a nice kind of little chair then on one end, plenty of natural light was beaming in when I shot this. You have a fan then as well, some more nice decorations, some more paintings, and on one end you kind of have a bedside table and some more decorations as well. But overall, it's kind of the view you could wake up to every morning if you choose to sleep up here. Really well done loft area. Hope you guys enjoyed the tour of this really cool newly renovated historic home in Shaftesbury, Vermont. If you did, please help me out. Give this video a like, give it a thumbs up. It helps to be shown to more people on the platform. And also consider subscribing if you're not yet subscribed to my channel. I have a ton of more videos coming for you guys in the next couple of months. About 30 or 40 more shoots, like literally planned out for the rest of the year in the United States in 2020. So tons of more videos coming your way every single week, maybe potentially twice per week. I'll be posting soon. So definitely subscribe to be notified about future videos. I'm also going to link out my playlist somewhere up here. Just some of my favorite unique Airbnbs, properties, hotels I've shot so far. Everything from tiny homes to tree houses to places like this. So I'm sure if you enjoyed this video, you can find some other videos on my channel that you might enjoy watching. So go check out some of my other videos. Thanks so much for the support, guys, and I'll see you next week.